All right, what's going on, guys? It's your man, I Stand Tall. I'm out here in Hong Kong on a yacht, as you guys can see. So I'm out here with the Sway fam. We're having a great time out here. If you guys hear some background music, that's just them having a good time over there. But real quick, in this video, I want to talk to you guys about... This is the fourth video in the Fundamental Forex section that I have been giving to you guys. And in this video, I want to talk to you guys about looking at the bigger picture, looking at the context. Because majority of traders fail because they don't understand how to read the data. And they also don't understand what the data means in the bigger picture. So in this video, in the last video, we talked about how to look at the forward guidance, how to go on Forex Factory and read and listen to the press conferences, read the monetary policy statement to get that tone of voice, whether where a central bank is hawkish. And if a central bank is hawkish, that means that they are looking to raise their interest rates. If a central bank is dovish, that means they are looking to lower their interest rates. The way that I remember it is that when a hawk flies up, a dove flies down. Obviously, a hawk is better than a dove. So this is kind of how I remember the verbiage. All right. But real quick, in this video, what I want to talk to you guys about is being able to put together the full context, the full bigger picture of all of the data that you're looking at. You see, a lot of times people think that a low unemployment rate is good and a higher unemployment rate is bad. And that's not always the case, all right? You got to understand, you got to look at the bigger picture. Where are we currently in the economy? Are we in an economy where we have high inflation and we're trying to get inflation back down? Are we in an economy where we have low inflation, but the economy is just not producing as much goods and services, which is GDP, or unemployment rate is high in a low inflation environment? So you really have to look at the overall bigger picture of the environment that you're currently in as the economy or the currency that you're looking to trade of that economy. So, for example, Bank of Japan has to keep their interest rates negative. And when they keep their interest rates negative, if Japanese people save their money in a bank, they have to pay a fee for saving their money in a bank because the interest rate is negative. Whereas in a high interest rate scenario, if you save your money in the banks will actually pay you to save your money in the bank. So the reason that this is set up this way is because in Japan, they don't want people to save their money. They want people to go out there and spend their money so they are not in a deflationary environment. And in video two, I believe we already talked about what is deflation and why that is bad and we don't want deflation. Because if the value of goods and services are constantly decreasing, people are going to hold on to their money and try to get a better price tomorrow and the day after and the day after. And this leads to less spending, means less demand, and the supply of goods keep increasing, which drives the value of the products down even more. So we don't want a deflationary environment, but at the same time, we don't want an environment where the inflation is too high. So when you're looking to trade and you're looking at the data and you're trying to put all of the pieces of the data together, you have to keep in mind, what is the bigger picture here? What is the context here? Because if without the right context, you're not going to get the right trading decision, the right directional bias on whether to take a currency long or short, whether to buy a currency because you believe it's going to appreciate or to sell a currency because you think it's going to depreciate. So you have to keep in mind the context. And the context is, in this environment, what is the primary objective of that central bank? Are they looking to decrease unemployment rate because inflation is low already? Or are they looking to kind of increase unemployment rate because inflation is already high? And the reason that we want, in a high inflationary environment, we kind of want unemployment rate to go up. Means we want less people to not have jobs. We want more people to not have jobs in the economy because that is going to decrease the amount of spending in the economy, which can bring the demand of goods and services down and supply up. So the value of goods and services doesn't increase as fast. All right. But if we're in an environment where we have low inflation and we want to stimulate the economy and the central banks are keeping interest rates low and they're in quantitative easing, means they're buying government bonds, then in that environment, we want unemployment rate to go down. So if you're in that environment and the unemployment rate is coming up, let's say non-farm payroll, wage growth, unemployment rate, all of those come out the first Friday of every week. We want all of those to be positive. We want unemployment rate to go down. We want more jobs to be added in the economy. We want wage growth to kind of increase because all of that means that there is a demand for workers in the economy And all of that is going to boost the production of that economy, which is what the central banks want for that environment. But if we're in an environment where inflation is already too high and we want to bring inflation back down, we want people to not have as many jobs. We don't want wage growth to increase. We don't want more jobs being added to the marketplace, and we want unemployment rate to go up. So in that environment, it's good if the unemployment rate goes up. So you have to really keep in mind the bigger picture. What is the story that you're creating about the economy when you're putting together all of the pieces of the data? When you're looking at each and every individual report, whether that's non-farm payroll, wage growth, unemployment rate, CPI, PPI, PCE, retail sales, core durable goods, all of these data individually don't mean nothing until you put them all together and they give you a story, a full picture of the economy. So this is video number 4, I believe. And I hope you guys got some value from this. If you did, leave a like, share, subscribe. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you want to learn more about this, if you want access to information that I cannot just give to you guys for free, then take my course, sign up for my mentorship. It'll be worth it. Trading is an amazing skill set. You can make as much money as you want, but only when you have the right education. People go to college and they spend hundreds of thousands of dollars to go and work a job, to spend 40 hours of their week to make 5 to 10K a month. You can do that in a day with trading if you understand the skill set and you understand the education and you get the right knowledge. So out here in Hong Kong on a yacht, bringing you guys the vibes. I should be down there with the Sway fam having fun. But I wanted to make this video for you guys because I'm committed. I'm dedicated to helping you guys get the best education. And if you're committed and you're dedicated to getting the best education, hit me up, follow me on Instagram, DM me on Facebook, hit me up, leave a comment below, whatever. Let's work together and I'll see if we're a good fit to work together because I don't just work with anybody. But if I like you, I trust you, I respect you, and I think you have a brain and you can actually make it with trading, well, I'll let you take my mentorship on my course and we'll work together and we'll make some shit happen. So thank you guys so much for watching. Stay blessed, and I'll see you guys.
On the way we shed some tears. Every day we sacrifice so we could be standing here. Oh, what a hell of a life. Been winning so many years, and the future is bright. Now it's very clear that we gon' be rich forever. I remember being blind to it till it did.